this was definitely the month for the eyes. I tried a couple of new eyeliners. First was the Maybelline Hyper Easy Liquid Liner. I love this. It's super black. It has a very soft brush tip. It retails for $8.99, and I think this is a great, tremendous value for your money. Definitely a darling. Next, I tried a new shade of the Pixi Endless Silky Eye Pen. This is very berry, and it is beautiful. I love this. These are super soft and creamy, but they do set and stay. I love that they have that ability for you to be able to blend them out, but then once they're blended out and they set, they are going to stay. So these retail for $12. Love those. The other new pencil I tried was from Urban Decay. It's one of their 24/7 glide-on pencils, but it's in the shade Tiger's Eye. One of you mentioned this to me, and it is beautiful. It is a mauve shimmer eyeliner, and it's pretty soft and subtle. I use this on the lower lash line. I suppose you could use this on your upper lid more as like a cream shadow base, and that would be really pretty too. It's not going to be a super bold statement, but I just love it. I did use it today and then put some shadow on top of it, but I do love and enjoy these. I've got a whole stash back there, so always love the Urban Decay eyeliners. And then I tried the Buxom Hold the Line eyeliner, another recommendation from one of you. And this is, here's my number. This is the black brown shade, and this is incredible. This has amazing stay power, especially in the waterline. Stays well on your lash line as well, but I have been trying this out my waterline. I have this down here in the lower lash line, and it is incredible. I also love that it comes with its own little pencil sharpener. So nice little value at $18. Next up are two of the Laura Mercier Caviar Sticks. I have the shade Cocoa and Metallic Taupe. Now, this is a sample size, but I did purchase the full size. And here's my take on these. These are really nice, super long wearing as eyeshadow bases. However, I've not really loved them just all on their own. So if you're looking for a really good kind of sticky eyeshadow base, and by sticky, I mean something to really grip the shadow, make it look more vibrant and stay all day, this is a great way to do it. This is Cocoa, this is Metallic Taupe. But really, for $29, I do feel like they're a little more on the pricey side. They do blend a little better than some of the other eyeshadow sticks that I've tried in the past, but I kind of feel like these are just in the mediocre category. I hate to say that. At first, I was really excited because I do love how the Cocoa blended out, but I've tried it on its own and it just did not make things quick for me at all. So I just still feel like it works better with a little bit of shadow on top. So putting those in the mediocre category, but they are really good products. But for the price point, yeah, I think that's where I'm gonna leave them. All right, next is the Charlotte Tilbury Eyes to Mesmerize. I have the shade Rose Gold, and here you go. This has, it is right here. It is a nice pink gold color. I'm so conflicted in this because it is a super smooth, soft, creamy formula. You almost don't think that it's really going to do anything, but when you put it on your lids, you do see that nice catch of the light. There really isn't much visible shimmer, if at all. But usually when I wear this, I go over the top of it with a powder shadow, and it does make that powder shadow look really super vibrant. It's $32, so this one is right on the precipice between darling and mediocre. Only reason why I say mediocre is because it's not one that I really love all on its own. I like it with something else, but it does look really beautiful, and I do think that it is really nice on mature eyelids. It doesn't make texture really stand out, so that would be where it would push it into the more darling category, but I'll let you decide for yourself. Again, $32. All right, this last cream eyeshadow stick. Oh my goodness. There is nothing subtle about this one. All right, this is the KVD Dazzle Stick. Okay, and I have the shade Force Field. I was trying to get something that was different than the other cream shadow sticks that I already have in my collection. And whoa, Nelly, this is beautiful. It is kind of the opposite of the Charlotte Tilbury. It is a dazzling shadow. Oh my goodness, there is a lot of glitter in there. And it does set and stay very quickly. This does work well underneath shadows or on its own. I do feel like this formula though is super soft. They did put it in the correct type of packaging because it's going to keep its shape here, but it's really, really soft. So I actually usually will apply it from here onto the eyes and not take this directly onto the eyes because you can get some chunks. But that aside, these retail for $22. And I mean, just look at that metallic finish. Oh my goodness. I think it's available in 5 colors and definitely planning to get more. So definitely a darling in my book. 2 mascaras that I tried. One is the Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir, and this is just the deluxe size. This does retail in the full size for $27. I actually really do enjoy this mascara. Is it better than my favorite It Cosmetic Superhero? No. I do find the brush to be even a little messier than the It Cosmetics, if that's possible, because it kind of flares out, gets fatter at the end there, and the It Cosmetics kind of tapers down, but it is a really nice volumizing mascara, and it does stay really well. I didn't have any problems with smudging or flaking through the day, so I'm going to put this in the darling category, but definitely not going to replace my favorite, but it is a very nice mascara. The other mascara, another one that a lot of people love, but sadly, this was a dud for me. This is the L'Oreal Unlimited Mascara. Now, I did love how my lashes looked with this. I did find that this wand made it actually surprisingly easy to kind of get the length. It is one of those rubber bristle brushes, which usually isn't my favorite, but the shape of the wand made it easy to get kind of in the corners. And I did like the overall look. However, I had flakes all day long, like little flakes here and there, and my eyes, I could not figure out why I wanted to just scratch my eyes out for several days in a row. And all of a sudden I was like, oh my goodness, I think it's the mascara. It does retail for $12.99, so it is more on the pricey side. And because of the flakes and the eye irritation, this one's going in the dud pile. All right, the last section in the eyes, eyeshadow palettes. Oh my goodness. I promise you, I'm going to just go through this quickly. And there's several eyeshadow palettes that I have already reviewed. So I will link those as we're going through here. First off, I tried these 5 palettes and I did a whole video on them. There are 2 from LA Girl, 2 from Huda, the Haze palettes, and then the Too Faced Salted Caramel palette. So I'm not even going to go into those. Look up here for a link. You can watch a video, see swatches, all that. The next palette, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail either, is the BK Beauty True Beauty palette. I did a Get Ready With Me video, which I will link up here, and it has swatches. I talk about the formulation and everything, so check out that video for my thoughts on that one. But I have a few palettes that I've not kind of given you my thoughts on since I've been using them. First is the Huda Beauty Naughty Nude palette. Aside from the names in this palette, and this really strange gel formulation that really doesn't do anything good for eyeshadow, the rest of these shadows, I've actually really enjoyed this palette. It retails for $67. I know that is a lot. I do have swatches in my Sephora haul video, which I'll link up here. But I am planning multiple looks with this palette just to show you how it is in action. But I personally have actually really enjoyed this. I think the formulation, the quality of the shadows, and just some of the unique finishes make it fun, but it is on the pricey side. So I am putting it in the darling category, but there are a few others probably out there, and one other that I'll show you today that I actually love even more. Next is another one that I showed in that Sephora haul video. It is the Natasha Denona Mini Zendo palette, and I have enjoyed this cute little palette. I think the standout shade by far is this center shade. It is really unique. Again, it's a little bit green, a little bit silver, a little bit gold, and I've really enjoyed these colors. I think you can get a very light look with it, but I do find myself pulling in a couple of other shades from another palette. But at $25, the quality is there, and so therefore it is going into my darlings category. Next is one I'm just going to mention from BoxyCharm. So if you are a BoxyCharm subscriber, you probably received this, or if you get a subscription, you might be able to shop this in their pop-up, and it is the Natasha Denona Peak palette. This was specifically designed for BoxyCharm. I'm just going to show it here because I love what she did here. She pulled in 5 shades that you can pull out several full complete looks with, and I love palettes like this. A little mini palette that has that cream brow bone shade. It has a darker color, it has one shimmer, and then it has a couple of crease options. Now, you know, you could make the argument it would be nice to have a different shade in here, but these are pulled from 3 of her large palettes. It's from Biba, Safari, and the Sunrise palette. And I just love this shade compilation. So definitely has been a darling, a big win for me. And this size Natasha palette usually retails for $48. So this was a great value in the BoxyCharm box. Next is one of the cutest and most beautiful palettes I have used, and I've not even shown you. It is the Marc Jacobs Cherrific palettes from their Very Merry Cherry collection. So it is limited edition. Here is the outer packaging. Is that not just darling? It's raised cherries with gold lettering. There's a raised cherry here. The inside, I saved the little clear part here because it has gold cherries on it. I just wanted to show you, but this is the color scheme. And if you know me, you know this is my kind of color scheme. And again, what I love about this compilation is I can get a full complete look with this palette. It has kind of it's almost more of a satin finish, but close to a matte finish cream shade, has super deep shade, this beautiful cranberry color, and this very unique kind of silvery lilac shade. And then it has kind of a similar product to the Charlotte Tilbury toppers. It has something like that right here. And this can do amazing things on top of these 2 shimmer shades. So I have really enjoyed this palette, and you know it's my kind of color scheme. This retails for $49.50, and it is a really good soft formula, but super pigmented and definitely a darling. Now, 2 quads that I talked about briefly in my Charlotte Tilbury Get Ready With Me video are these, and it is the Pillow Talk Luxury Palette and the Luxury Palette of Pops. So let me show you these. These retail for $53 each. Now, the one thing that I have learned to really appreciate and love about these palettes are these pop shades. So this one that has an entire palette of pops, especially these 2 lighter ones, and then in the Pillow Talk palette, this one. I have really enjoyed these topper kind of shades. If I get done with a look and I'm just like, oh, I'm just not quite feeling that shade of shimmer on the lid, or I want just a little something extra, I'll just quickly rub my finger in that topper shade, go over the top of that shadow on the lid, and it just magically adds a little bit of sparkle, kind of smooths out the look of it, and just steps up the look just a smidge. So for that reason, they're not all out duds. They are a really nice formula. I just have struggled with the price for 4 shadows. Just seems like a lot. And the final eyeshadow palette, it is what I am wearing on my eyes today. And this was a huge surprise. This is the Lawless The Baby one, and it has 8 shades. 6 of them are matte and 2 shimmers. And I just think this is a wonderful compilation of colors. Now, it is missing that brow bone highlight shade, but otherwise, I feel like the compilation of colors in here really gives you a lot of options. And we don't have just your basic boring kind of neutrals. You know, we've got a really deep plum. We have kind of a mauvey pink shade. We do have a nice red that you can kind of have some fun with. If you mix it with this one, can make it a little more orange. This shade is what I have in my crease today. And it is like a berry brown. And then this is a nice deep cool brown. And then these 2 shades are beautiful. This one I used it wet on my lids today. It is a beautiful rose gold shimmer. And then this one is a super brightening inner corner highlight. This is super smooth. And so this retails for $25. I think this is a great palette, perfect for travel, or if you are just in a hurry and you need simple looks, this is a great little palette. All right, guys, we made it. That is the end of my list of new products I've tried. Oh my word. Now, I hope that this was helpful for you. If there are any products that I piqued your interest on that you want to hear more about or see more demos on, eyeshadow palettes you want to see looks with, let me know in the comment section below. And be sure you tune in next month to see all of the new products that I am currently testing out in December. Thank you as always so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.